So when we last spoke...
Yes, so you're going to try and finish that interview.
We had a somewhat malfunctioning interview where I nearly fell over and killed myself, but we talked about questions you get asked a lot. What's the question so far today that you've been asked a lot?
Are you any good at maths?
Are you?
No.
Well, we've nailed that.
We have, haven't we?
Absolutely.
That was fascinating,
that was
wasn't
brilliant.
It? I know.
God, this is going well. You learned skateboarding, you told me, for Say When.
Yeah.
What skills did you learn for this?
Well, I mean, it should have... Again, going back to the mathematics, I should be saying something mathematical and puzzle-solving things, but I didn't, because I couldn't, because my brain doesn't work in that way.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too. Yeah.
And you shot some of this up in, actually near where I live, in Nettlebed in Oxfordshire.
Oh.
What's the nightlife like there? And also, what was the rap party like for this?
Big town. I didn't go to the rap party because I was on holiday. Because literally the day we finished, I went off. So I don't know. I can imagine that it would be pretty good though.
Yeah.
It was a good bunch of, you know, of good guys who could drink well. So I think, and a Norwegian who can definitely drink very well.
Say
no more. I can imagine that it would have been quite fun.
For sure.
Yeah.
Well, I'll ask Benedict.
You'll ask Benedict. I'm sure he was there.
Now, we also talked about renaming titles of your films, because Begin Again and Songs to Save Your Life and Say When and Laggies. What would you rename The Imitation Game?
That's tricky. What would you rename The Imitation Game?
Enigma. No, that's...
Yeah. That's true. I don't know. Yeah. Oh, I don't know. I was going to try and make an anagram of The Imitation Game.
I'd be so impressed.
I would be so impressed. Well, you know, they've been doing that to me all day, and now I can't remember any of the... I can't even say it. The alalala?
A llamagram.
The alalala, yeah.
You have to... A word with the word llama in it. You have done, so far this year, 4 movies. You've also been in every single genre I can think of. You've done a horror, you've done a...
I haven't done a horror.
Is the whole a bit of
Oh, you're right. Oh, I've forgotten. Yes, you're right. Sorry, I've done a horror. Yeah, go on.
You forget. You've done so many.
Done so many.
You know, period pieces, obviously, rom-coms.
Yeah.
Is there anything that you're really jonesing for now?
I'm quite interested in sci-fi. I like sci-fi books.
Anything particular?
Some of them. Nothing particular. I mean, I don't have like a favourite, but I'm getting into a bit of a Philip K. Dick. I might go in that. I went, you know, via a kind of Ballardian type thing and into a Philip, you know. So I think I suppose I haven't done a sci-fi.
Okay.
But I wouldn't... You see, sci-fis now, they're just action movies, really. Whereas that's not what sci-fi books are. They're so melancholy and so sort of strange. And the only film that I can... Well, Moon did that brilliantly.
That's true.
Think that absolutely got that kind of proper sci-fi thing. So if there was something along the vibe of a Moon type thing, then there you go.
All right, good.
Not that there is. There isn't.
No.
By the way, I've read what's out there and I haven't found one yet.
Moon 2.
Moon 2, can you imagine? Now it's a girl playing all the roles.